Hey guys, it's Greg with by the Bootstraps, btbootstraps.com. Check out the store, check out the social media, even though there's not a lot on there right now. Store's still up and running. Been gone for a hot minute, obviously. Moved from Minnesota to Arizona. Had a lot of things that were happening, things going on. Anyway, reason why I wanted to make this video and the reason why I wanted to, you know, get back online is that I've been watching this whole entire controversy going on with Bud Light and Dylan Mulvaney and all this other stuff, and I'll explain that as I go. So, Bud Light, in their infinite wisdom, decided to hire this transgender activist by the name of Dylan Mulvaney, right? Which is an actual dude. He's a biological male who has been masquerading and parading around for the last year as a woman. In fact, I forget exactly what day it was on, but he did this whole entire special saying that day 365 of being a woman, which, that's fine. I don't like it, and I don't like the idea, and it's not because I have anything against transgender people or anything like that. I think it's a mental disease, and I think they need, you know, professional help to deal with whatever issues that they're dealing with, because science, you know, follow the science, as we get told, comes down to really being one of two things. Either A, biologically, you're born as a male, or you're born as a female. And I've made other videos in the past regarding this, and I could probably give more information and context into that, but I don't want to do this right here because that's not really what the interest of the video is. The interest is that all these people... All right, let me back up. Bud Light, along with Nike, and Tampax and other sponsors, corporate media sponsors, had decided to sponsor this biological male to be the face of females, okay? Ironically, the big one that's being boycotted at the moment is Anheuser-Busch, who owns Bud Light, because they decided to do a special event video where his face was gonna be on the side of a can, which is ironic and creepy at the same time. Now, I don't know if the marketing director for Bud Light just doesn't understand their brand or who their customers are, but from when I used to go to the bar and when I used to, you know, go out and drink and whatever, people who were buying Bud Lights were anyone between 22-year-old men, males, girls, to, you know, 50, 60-year-old guys and girls, right? It was a broad spectrum. But I could tell you this, they were usually hardworking, blue-collar individuals, right? Yeah, you might get some progressives, you might get some liberals or whatever, but for the most part, like, I'm not even talking about conservative or Democrat or anything like that, Republican, Democrat, that's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying they were usually hardworking, no foo-foo drinks, just wanted to go to the bar, have a couple drinks, buy a six-pack, a 12-pack, whatever, 24-pack, and just sit down at a bonfire and just enjoy themselves. So they hire this trans activist to essentially be the face of Budweiser. And then lo and behold, the community as a whole revolted. And now the stock has gone down 30% in 1 week. You know, I think they went from, I forget the exact numbers, but they basically lost basically $4 million in a week's time frame. And it's still plummeting. It's still going down. You have representatives who are like backing out of it. You have affiliates who are backing out of it. You have sales managers from liquor stores, individuals, and bars who are backing out of it. They're basically not just Bud Light, but like Anheuser-Busch in general. So you're talking all the products that Anheuser-Busch, you know, provides. You know, it's affecting all these people, to include the employees of those establishments, you know, the affiliates of those establishments, and everyone who actually works in that supply chain, which I feel sorry for those people. But then you also have the same companies that were like, you know, Tampax and Nike. Nike decided to sponsor this guy, this biological male who does not have breasts. He has, I don't know if he has augmentation or did he get surgery or maybe wearing like a padded suit or something. I'm not quite sure. And quite frankly, I don't want to know. I don't want to see it. But they decided to make this man, the biological male, the face of their marketing campaign for women's sports equipment. Well, that's interesting. How are you going to make a sports bra ad for a biological male who does not have breasts? And even if he had augmentation, it's still not a female. You know, how are you going to make leggings and everything for a biological female, have a biological male be the representative of the brand, and yet he's got a bulge in the center where she would not. And probably the most egregious, and honestly the one that I don't understand why people have not gotten more upset by, is the fact that you have Tampax made him the spokesperson for tampons. What exactly does he know about using tampons, and why, and when you would? You know, my wife is 34, 35 right now. She's been, you know, a biological female for over, you know, 10,000 days, 20,000 days. I don't see anyone coming out of the clouds and be like, you've done such a good job, you rock. But this guy who plays a caricature of a woman gets all this, you know, this credence of somehow being more authoritative of a biological sex that he's not even part of, and yet you have biological women who are being completely ignored. And then you had that swimmer recently here at that college who was assaulted, you know, not even just verbally but also physically assaulted, because she had the luxury of swimming against Leah Thompson, who is a biological male who ranked so low in the men's swimming competition, decided that he was a woman, and then transferred over to the women's division, smoked all the girls, and yet still hasn't gone through the surgery to remove his, you know, productive organs. I'll put it that way. I'm trying to be very G-rated here. But yet this guy, literally a guy, claims he's a woman, beats her at her own sport, and she was ranked number one in the nation prior to Mr. I want to wear a wig and, you know, some pressed on nails decides that he's a woman. And yet she's called the transphobe, the bigot, you know, trans rights or human rights is what they were screaming at her. As, by the way, a trans activist was punching her, which was a male who said he was a woman. Oh, so it's okay when your side decides to get violent and get destructive and everything else, but if people like me or anyone else say, like, hey, we don't agree with this, oh, we're the bigots. We're the violent ones. We're the ones who are causing so much trouble. Except I don't think we're the ones mass shooting a Christian school. Oh, wait, that just happened. Oh, I'm sorry. My bad. Too soon? Or we weren't the ones who were recently stopped by the parents of another person who was going to go commit a mass shooting, and their parents actually reported this person, this 19-year-old, as being mentally unstable, locked them in. But yet, we're the ones who are the intolerant ones. Okay, that's fine. However, I have a daughter, I have a wife, I have a mother. All of them were born women and still continue to be women, and I think they're well beyond the 365 threshold as what this Dylan Mulvaney person's getting. But yet no one cares about their feelings. No one gives a damn about what they think. No one even, you know, bats an eye about what it affects them. If my daughter has to compete against a young boy, and this young boy smokes her ass in any kind of competition because of the strength, you know, especially as they start developing more. I mean, right now she's 12, so 13, 14, 15, 16. When development actually starts kicking in and this guy, by natural stance, physically whoops her ass, is anyone going to speak for my daughter? Or if my wife says that, hey, I've been a woman for, you know, 33, 34 years, is anyone going to care about her standpoint, about how she feels, or maybe the fact that she feels uncomfortable if a grown-ass man walks into a changing room or a locker room to change with her, and she says, hey, I feel completely uncomfortable with this because this guy has a penis still. Are they going to escort him out, or are they going to escort her because she's just intolerant? How dare you? Or my, you know, 60-year-old mother, same situation, not a threat to anyone if she stands up for herself, but this, you know, trans dude comes walking in and says, all of a sudden, I'm a female. And then basically the exact same situation, let's say she's at Target or Walmart using the restroom, and all of a sudden here comes a guy who's standing at a urinal, which they don't have in females' bathroom. That's my point. It's that absurd. Does she not have a right to sit there and say, hey, I'm completely uncomfortable with this as a woman? Oh, wait, no, they're the bigots. they're the ones who just don't understand. You know, Bud Light has bitten off more than they could chew, because the backlash of what they got was well beyond what they actually thought it was going to be. You know, and then I listened to the marketing director, the woman who came out there and said, inclusivity is like so important. No, it's not. And not only that, inclusivity literally goes both ways. Inclusivity does not mean we just include one side of the spectrum and completely ignore the other side. And guess what? I'd say 3-4 billion right now kind of says the same thing. I can't wait to watch these companies that continue doing this kind of falter to the ground and die out, because this is what you guys wanted, this is what you preached for, and now you're reaping the rewards of what you've done. Anyway, if you liked the video, I know it's been a moment, check out the store, check out the social media. I'll talk to you guys later.